को विराम दे रहा हूं, धन्यवाद।
सर increase in the speed of the flight. Last a few months, it has been is from 5 kilometers, 60 kilometers. Opportunity of trade. We're very happy. They're getting the flight from like Bihar all the way to within less than 24 hours, which is never heard of, sir. So congratulations, sir. And also the second thing, with regards to your ministry's ideas regarding increase in the speed of the passenger trains as well. I've been seeing it. They want to increase it to 180 kilometers. It's a good move, sir. And the third being, the last few years, there's a drastic decrease in the accidents that have been happening. It is also, we have to congratulate the ministry and all the people that have been participating in this for making it happen. But sir, I have some specific questions regarding the operation and financial situation of the railways. First, the operation ratio of the railways have worsened from 90% in 2012-13 to 96% in 21-22, sir. This higher operational ratio reflects the expenses of the railways have been rising faster than the revenues. So I would like to know from the ministry what is being done to improve the operational ratio so that the financial situation is maintained, so that the railways is financially sustainable for the passengers and freight traffic, sir. The second one, the capital expenditure budgeted for the 2021 is higher than the budgeted estimate for 2021, sir. However, the question is around the implementation status of the capital expenditure allocation. In 2021, there has been underachievement on physical targets of construction of new lines by minus 40%, gauge conversion by minus 33%, doubling of lines by minus 26%, wagons by minus 17%, and track renewals by minus 20%. This happened when there's a COVID situation across the country, when the tracks are not being used. When if you have used this allocated budget well, we would have created lakhs of employment across the country, sir. This is what we have seen in the last one year. So I would like to know from the ministry what is being done to spend the capital expenditure budget of 2.15 lakh crores effectively in 2021-2022. Third, the draft National Railway Plan has also estimated that in 2021-2022, 3.1 lakh crores will be needed for projects under the National Infra Pipeline, sir. I would like to know from the ministry how the how they will create the infra where there is a budget allocation shortfall of almost 1 lakh crores, sir. Because we have already announced and we were little happy. I won't say that we are very, very happy when it comes to Andhra Pradesh. When we heard about the freight corridor between Vijayawada to Kharagpur and Vijayawada to Itachi. So if these things, these freight corridors has to happen and see the day of the light, where are the budgets coming from? Because you already shortfall by almost 1 lakh crores, sir. Coming to the issues with my state of Andhra Pradesh, sir, AP Reorganization Act 2014 has committed that the ministry will create a new railway zone in Andhra Pradesh within 6 months. It has been more than 6 years since the bill was passed, and the people of Andhra Pradesh are still waiting for the work to begin on the South Coast Railway Board, sir. Even though this is a new zone, even though the new zone was announced, the creation of Railway Recruitment Board was not announced, sir. Correct me if I'm wrong, but it is general practice that RRB is attached to every railway division, but this was ignored in the announcement of the South Coast Railway Zone, sir. On the one hand, the promises made to Andhra Pradesh has not been fulfilled. On the other hand, the existing Walter division is being wound up and one half being merged with Raigad division in Orissa, sir. I wish to remind the house that the Walter division is one of the highest revenue earning divisions in the country, sir. It is one of the leading revenue earners for the freight. In 2019-20, it earned close to 8,200 crores from the freight alone, sir. We request the ministry work dedicatedly towards fulfilling the commitments made in AP Reorganization Act, sir, allocating funds exclusively for the South Coast Railway Zone and give us timelines on which and when it will be functional, sir. We also request that the Walter division be retained as it is, as it serves the important functions of providing freight services for AP, because AP also has a lot of major ports, sir. Coming to issues regarding our states, the first one being Kisan Rail. It is a brilliant move by the central government to bring in Kisan Rail, and we have seen the benefits in one of the districts in Andhra Pradesh, in Anantapur, where it is functioning with full capacity, sir. But I think there is a need for the ministries to sit together and work out, sir, with regards to MOFP, Agriculture Ministry, and Railway Ministry, because coming from a district like Guntur, where the major produce is chilies and turmeric, which is spices, it is not being added in that category. So it is only given to vegetables and the pulses, sir. It is not the spices are not being added. So when I try to understand what is the thought behind it, even they don't have the idea about it, sir. Once I would like the it has to be included, sir. And second, with regards to Nadikudi Kalahasti line, sir, the work has been progressing for so many years, and it has been, but the speed at which it is going is not being done in that speed, sir, because it gives a lot of impetus for the growth in the highlands of Andhra Pradesh. Third being Gadwal and Macharla. The Gadwal and Macharla line, which connects both Telangana and Andhra, it's not such a big distance. It has been planned so many years ago, almost 15, 16 years ago, but somehow it is not seeing the day of the light, sir. And ROBs, I'm sure the ministry is facing these issues day in and out. The design of ROBs and ROBs, RUBs itself is a huge issue in our constancy, sir. RUBs, wherein water keeps logging in the winter, in a rainy season, sir, wherein almost 3 to 4 months, no one can pass through that, sir. There's some sort of a design flaw or something like that, sir. I think the ministry has to look into it. And also the ROBs. The issue with the ROBs is you're asking the state government to chip in 50% of the amount, sir. But most of the municipalities where these ROBs has to come up, they don't have these kind of revenues so that they can fund these ROBs, sir. And the other issue is with regards to stations, deductions, number of stoppages. With regards to that, correct me if I'm wrong, sir, but what I heard from the railways was that if we cannot get 50 tickets for that specific train in that station, that stop will be taken out. That's what I've been given the answer, sir. Correct me if I'm wrong, but most of these stations where this 50 tickets has to be cut, they don't have that reservation capacity. So if you say, for example, a station have 5 ticket reservation, how do you expect 50 tickets to be sold in that station, sir? So eventually, though, the passenger capacity will be decreased. Eventually, the whatever the notes you will get is, yes, there are not many people are getting on the train in the particular station because there is not reservation facility is not available, sir. So I hope you'll look into it, sir. And coming to regards to upgradation of in my constancy, coming to upgradation of Nasrabet railway station, sir, the new district is being formed, and I hope the ministry will look into it so that the upgradation of the station will happen as soon as possible, sir. And with along with that, the upgradation of stations in the line that comes from Sikandarabad to Guntur, Satinpalli, Pidugala, Nadikudi, these stations, there is already a plan to upgrade these stations, but and also Tirupati, which is a town wherein a lot of pilgrims come, sir. There is already a plan to upgrade these stations, sir, but it is not happening as per the speed that is being prescribed, sir. So I hope the ministry will look into these issues and make sure that everything is being taken into account and try to solve it as soon as possible. Thank you very much, sir.
Good. Sri Nama Nageswarrao ji.
Thank you, Chairman, sir.